Now let's pay attention to the energy balance in a steady flow process. Now steady flow means that whatever mass that enters, the same amount of mass leaves. So with steady flow, I would like to say that the rate of mass inflow is equal to the rate of mass outflow. Okay. Now at the entrance, you have the elevation from the reference plane as Z1. The fluid enters with a pressure P1, with a specific volume V1, with the internal energy of U1, that specific enthalpy as H1, and velocity V1. The similar values are on the section 2, which is the exit. You have some rate of heat input, which is Q dot, and you have some rate of work output, which is W dot. Okay. Now, if you look at the, you can say the balance of energy. So net energy across the boundary, okay, in the form of heat and work, this is equal to the energy at exit, that is section 2, minus the energy at inlet, that is section 1. Okay. Now the net energy across the boundary in the form of heat and work is basically Q dot minus W dot, that is the rate of heat and work, that is kilojoule per second or kilowatt. Now the total energy at exit is M dot, because I am assuming that M1 is equal to M2, so I'll just take M throughout into. So you have energies, which is a combination of specific internal energy, that's 2, plus the flow work at the exit, plus the kinetic energy at exit, plus the potential energy at exit. That's the total energy. Okay, minus, you again have M dot into U1 plus P1 V1, okay, plus V1 square by 2 plus Z1 G. So this is what you have. Now if you combine these terms, U plus PV, this is H2 and this is H1, that is enthalpy and at exit and at inlet. So this becomes M dot into H2 plus V2 square by 2 plus Z2G, okay, minus you have M dot into H1 plus V1 square by 2 plus Z1G. So this becomes your energy balance. Okay, if you take M common, this would become Q dot minus W dot is equal to M dot into, you can take these two, you have H2 minus H1, okay, then you have plus M dot into V2 square minus V1 square by 2, that's the difference of the kinetic energies, plus M dot into Z2G minus Z1G. So this is the entire equation we are interested in, and this is corresponding to a steady flow. Okay, so this kind of an equation is called a steady flow energy equation, and that is SFEE. Okay, so this is a very, very important equation to understand and to remember in the energy, you can say the flow process application of first law. Okay, so I hope you understood this very easy analysis. Now let's move on to the next video and start discussing about the application of steady flow energy equation on various devices.